Unbelievable.
So where am I right now?
Check this out. Unbelievably gorgeous. The weather is amazing. Probably 17 degrees Celsius, no wind. I'm on the edge of a mountain. Absolutely insane. And here's Kenny. He just wanted to say that he hikes more than me. So he got out of the car so he could say that he did more on his feet. So he's a better man than me. So we survived the 4x4 experience.
You survived. You survived.
Ken just got out of the car because he wanted to say he hiked there. More than me.
I fully barfed back there.
It was cute.
It's cute.
And now we have started on our epic journey to the top with a million other people. That's unfortunate. Ken cannot make the climb. He is just sick. He feels like he has the flu. He's like a 7.5 out of 10 sick. He got sick halfway up the drive. We thought it was motion sickness. Maybe it is, maybe it's the flu. But he is not feeling well. So he said, Todd, you've got to go to the top and just catch him as he walks back down. It's unfortunate, but we're gonna make the best of this. Came over that ridge behind me and suddenly the temperature dropped about, I don't know, 4 or 5 degrees. I was starting to regret wearing this long sleeve shirt. So now it's perfect. And it's only gonna get cooler from here. Came over another ridge, temperature dropped again, but I'm near the top. That is where you end up, and the views on the other side of that, insane. Okay, I get to the good views. And put yourself in my shoes if you've never done this before. With what you're about to see. Amazing. And that's not even the best view. Another 5-minute climb and then you'll really see it. All the way up there we go. Agassiz Bridge and the Fraser River goes all the way out to the ocean. Pretty cool, pretty cool. Is for you when your favorite mountains way over there in the distance. There's Baker. Trek back down and get some good views as we get down there. Here's another view of Baker in its majesty, and we'll get down to the car and find out how far Ken has made it down the Forest Service Road. Kenny, hope you're doing well. Hope you're not suffering too much. I missed you. We'll do this again together for sure, man. Absolutely, we're doing this again. guys back there looking awfully tired, taking a break, asked me how long it was to the top. And I said, well, you're about halfway. And he said, so about 2 hours? I said, no, like 40 minutes, 30, 40 minutes. So they looked very relieved. If I had to do it again, I'd say 45 minutes, but close enough. They'll get there. And I am indeed probably more than halfway down at this point. Here's my view. Well, it suddenly got warm. Now that I'm down under those ridges and into the alpine, it suddenly got nice and toasty. So I'm probably about 15 minutes away from the Jeep, and it was a fantastic hike so far. Lots of people, more people than I seem to remember, but it's not true. So away I go, continue this thigh quad pounding walk down this mountain. Well, that's it. The hike is in the history books. I went up, I came down, and I'm about to get my run on. And since it's going to be pretty flat back to the Jeep, I'm going to run back to the Jeep, find my buddy Ken, see how he's doing, and I'll be signing off for now. If you guys ever have a chance to get up to Chilliwack Valley, hike Cheam Mountain, oh my goodness, it is absolutely worth it. All right, until next time.